That was the bell. I'm sure Kevin will be here momentarily. Let's call to order the Board of Health meeting on June 12th, 2018. I know what we are due to have public discussion. I know, at least from the email I got last night, that we will be having someone presenting tonight, so I guess we can go on to our own business for now. Maybe we should, maybe we can wait for Kevin to approve the minutes.
Can I just take a moment of personal privilege?
Sure.
Heidi, I want to thank you for serving on the board for the last year. You filled a very important role at an important time. I'm sorry there was a disconnect with your working schedule.
Yeah, it was harder than I anticipated.
We're going to try to actually fix that going forward. So in the future, who knows?
Yeah, just because we are in healthcare, just like my schedule's made out, and I'm working two jobs now, which I think I was, but more now, so I'm working pretty much 40 hours.
So will this be your last meeting, Heidi?
Or is there one next Tuesday?
Are you posted for the selectmen?
We will be posted.
I mean, I can go next the 19th, but then it would just be the end of June.
Yeah, I think you're effective the end of June.
Yeah.
Sure, so thank you.
Just a question, Jim. What was the presentation going to be on tonight?
Tonight, David Zeke will be coming about, I believe, a gas line. I got email last night. I got home from work at like 9:30, 10 o'clock last night, and I had an email regarding a presentation he wanted to give, I believe, for like gas lines and gas safety.
Oh, okay. Just was curious. I didn't know how long it was going to be at this stage.
Okay.
Thank you.
But we do have public discussion for 5:30, so he may be not coming until 5:30.
And Kevin will be here in 15 minutes.
Okay. Is he next week? So next week? I can come to that, yeah.
So tonight's, next week's meeting will depend on how much we finish this evening.
Oh, that's true, yeah. Okay. Yep. And presumably a voted position on the board, sending this forward. Will be necessary.
Yes. Well, we do have a few changes to make that we to bring up and approve. I guess I can start with the chair report. That seems as though we did get a new public health nurse hired. The nurse's name is Rahima Shaban. I have not met her yet, and I actually did not see much of her resume of what I was thinking. She may be here tonight. Her original start date, I believe, was yesterday.
The 11th.
But she is not started yet. Do we have a start date that she will be starting?
I think it's sometime next week.
Next week? Okay. No, I'll look forward to working with her. and especially with some of the work that I'd love to get her on board and get started with that. That would be great. So we look forward to seeing her. Will she be able to make meetings, or will she make a meeting so we can?
I would like her to come to the first meeting after she's hired. She's here. That way she could meet everyone.
But as far as the rest of her hours, she probably would not have enough hours to come to our meeting. So
if we need her to, she can.
Okay.
Sure.
And what are the, bless you, jeez.
That was perfect timing.
Wasn't it?
One other note, a CDC warning has been issued this past, late last week, of an outbreak of salmonella poisoning, mostly in Midwestern states, but they're still, CDC is still investigating for other states. It seems as though a manufacturer, the name is Kato Foods out of Indianapolis, that packages cut fruit. There has been a salmonella outbreak with that. So I would just warn people if one does purchase cut fruit, melons, especially watermelons, cantaloupes, melons of any type that are prepackaged, just be very careful. I would check to see who packages it. As of right now, there's no cases in Massachusetts, but there are 8 states that is involved with and they're investigating.
Is the romaine lettuce thing resolved?
Well, the growing season for the, that was Yuma, Arizona lettuce. They no longer are growing in Arizona. They're now into California growing. And it seems to be no problems in California. So that pretty much is over as far as I'm aware. And they still didn't get to the bottom of that either, because not only was there prepackaged lettuce, but then there was whole heads of lettuce that were given in a prison in, I think, California, that they found some E. coli on that also. So they're still investigating that. That's about all I have as far as the public health front from my end. I don't know if Laura, for the health agent report, if you've got any information for us around town.
Actually, nothing interesting. I wanted to know if you had anything that you wanted to discuss on Lincoln and Prescott. It seems like everything's...
Yeah, I have not heard any complaints of that. Everything seemed to be going fine. The DEP, I guess it issued them some advisories.
Yes.
As far as I'm aware, they're conforming with the advisories.
So I hear, right? Neighborhood's been quiet.
Yep.
Is it? Okay, I haven't heard anything either.
It has, I just...
Now, I noticed they had a pile of soil that was covered. Usually that means like a 21E issue or something. Do you know why
I did not see that.
But it's gone now. You know.
Okay. No, I don't know. Was that dug up?
Yeah, dug up soil that had plastic over it.
Hmm. Okay.
Whatever, I guess the DEP said it was okay to move.
Mm-hmm.
It wouldn't have been moved otherwise.
Yeah, I wasn't even aware of that, but there is a supervisor on site that is taking care of all that.
For sure.
All,
at least.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And John Fralick, Bob Bracey, and myself have all been reappointed for animal inspections. So we're in the beginning stages of renewing all the animal permits. So we'll just have to go around and check everyone's coops.
Now, one thing, is John Fralick, is he working, is it Woburn? His primary,
is on the job?
Yes.
Is it Woburn? He's Stoneham. His father's Woburn.
Stoneham. Okay. I just wasn't sure. Okay.
I'm not positive if his father's Woburn or not, but I know his father is.
I read was it Jack Fralick or John Fralick? I thought it was Woburn, that they had some rodent issues, I guess, in Woburn.
Yeah, that was his father.
That was his father.
I remember the story. I just wasn't sure on the town. And then everything else was just routine inspections.
Whatever happened with the school? Did they get their water? Was hot water?
Yeah, one of the schools didn't have hot water one day. But it was up and running before they opened the next morning. So it didn't make a blimp.
The minutes, should we wait for, we should probably wait for Kevin to approve the minutes.
Do you have anything you want to change on the minutes in the meantime?
I do.
Yeah, because Heidi wasn't in that. Probably
I didn't notice any problems.
Okay.
Family Day. Does anybody serve hot food at that needs inspections, and is that going smoothly? Preparation for that.
As of right now, nothing. We started getting some permits for September 1, though.
Yeah, maybe they're not really. They did sell pizzas last year. If they're prepared elsewhere, do they need a permit?
If they're prepared in the town, then they need a permit, but they don't need to.
Not there. Yeah.
Right, they don't need to pay for it. But if they're on an outside location, then they need to.
Is that this coming weekend?
Yeah, Saturday. 10:30 to 3.
Friends and family this weekend? Okay. Nothing. Okay. No, we have no permits for it. As far as I'm aware, no one's...
There's a lot more in the fall.
But they've already started coming in for the fall street fair. Camps are starting.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Oh, in the minutes, under public discussion on the minutes, can we just go back to that for a minute?
It's like there might be a typo.
Yeah, so the first sentence, let's press aside, let's just put an S on regulations, because that's what they are stated further in the paragraph, at the end of the first sentence.
Regulations.
Yes, third sentence, use of the last name there, said, she, there, may be a change in direction. She said, she, there, she is concerned. You see what I'm saying, John? Third sentence.
Oh, yeah, said, she, there, may be a change.
She said, she is concerned.
Said, she, there, may be.
She further stated?
No.
O'Neill?
Okay. The third sentence, O'Neill said, she, there, may be a change. You see that, John?
Yes.
Out she.
No. No, she is concerned. Sentence. Is concerned needs to be added.
She is concerned, there may be. It's like two words were left out.
She is concerned, there may be. Okay.
Right. That last sentence it's not even commented that the pesticides are dangerous for pets and people run their baby carriages through the pesticides. It's dangerous for pets and
I was concerned because I've seen a lot of people with baby carriages and they might go through them.
Yeah, she didn't say run their baby carriages.
Yeah, sort of makes it sound like they're purposely running through them.
Yeah, can that just be reworded a little bit?
Dangerous for pets, comma.
And people run their baby carriages through the pesticides?
And how about baby carriages may pass through, baby carriages may pass over public land containing pesticides?
Yeah.
Do you want to take it now while we have it? Just review it. Copy me, sir. Under chair report, just the minutes of 5:15. Third sentence under the first paragraph. I think what I questioned was if the legislation covered purchase, possession, and use, any of the three, or all three. And you responded to the purchase.
Purchase,
possession, and use.
And use.
And Wellesley is L-E-Y, third paragraph of the chair.
Yes, L-E-Y.
Mm-hmm. So what did you want a paragraph about to change in
Ends may your question if the legislation covered it should read purchase, possession, and use.
And then I stated it just pertains to purchases.
Yes.
Both purchase, possession, and use.
All three.
Stated it covered you purchase.
Purchase.
Okay.
Purchase age and purchase locations. guess on the next page where it's, I agree that in order to be sold, pesticides are classified as safe, and I guess I would put safe as advertised.
As when, directed? Or as
well, when used, at, when used as directed, or on label.
Right.
At, as directed on label.
So add on label?
Classified as safe. When used as directed.
So, so if it's, if we're changing, do we have to check the video to make sure, like it's stated, or can we change?
Well, that's, I mean, that it, it's more of a semantic thing, I guess. I just wanted to clarify the language. It, it classified as safe and advertised as use as directed. So I was just semantically putting it grammatically a little bit different. Classified as safe when used as directed.
I think it's more likely that's what you said.
I can double check that because I want to double check exactly what Ms. Snyder stated as well.
Well, it looks like it's been abbreviated. I
well, no, that's yeah. Why I'll look it up and make sure, I'll watch the video and make sure.
Yeah, no, it just, I just for grammar purpose, that's all.
Get this one out of the way early. On the pesticide draft, section 6 exemptions, does one of those cover spraying for mosquitoes? The town does?
No. This has nothing to do with mosquito spraying. That's
Is that covered somewhere else, or
is,
number, not, is that not prohibited?
That is not prohibited.
It's exempted.
I believe that's a biological anyway, isn't it? The mosquito spraying.
Not everything. BT earlier in the year, yeah. If they have an outbreak, I think they use other low end pesticides. That's when people want to mark their property if they don't want to be sprayed, that sort of thing. As long as we're not, you know, our hands aren't tied from doing that, because that's all pretty well regulated elsewhere.
I don't even think we mentioned that in here as far as spraying.
Okay. Yeah, if you could look into it before the hearing, before we talk next week, that would be good.
We specifically excluded town employees also from this.
Right. They're already called protected. Oh, I see. So if they do the spraying, they're presumably operating within their four quarters.
Well, I think, yes, that's because we have no right purview over town employees' jobs and responsibility.
Sure. Here it comes. Sorry, folks. Sorry, yeah. Sorry. Traffic and babysitters.
Hi there. Hey.
Hi.
Hey, Steve. Oh, good old Kevin. Good, now that I'm here. Okay.
We were just reviewing the minutes, Kevin.
Perfect.
If you had any comments on the minutes.
Hi.
Come back to me. I actually haven't had a chance to look at them over the weekend.
Okay. Would the publication of the regulations. When we do submit these to the selectmen, and assuming that they do get, we do get the ability to take responsibility for town land, if that is the decision of the board to allow us to do, we would have, before we instituted the regulations, I would like to, as Kevin brought up, I would like to publicize the regulations.
Yes.
I had a few ideas on where we may publicize them. I don't know if anyone else had a chance to sort of brainstorm on where we would publicize the regulations. We definitely our own website. I'm thinking we could put them on our own website. The town website, can we put them up on the town website in addition to our own website?
Sure.
These drafts actually came off the town website.
Well, it's under your part.
It's on our Board of Health. Is it on the town website also? The
oh, it's on the Board of Health section.
Yeah. So I think that's all right.
I think, yeah. Just talk to Matt. He'll get it done.
Okay. The local newspapers, maybe a public service announcement.
Post and patch.
Yep.
Patch.
Don't forget the water bills. People do read those.
Well, that was one of the things I had.
I think that would be the big one, actually.
Water bills.
We'll get that shop that for 3 months.
The Public Works newsletter, is that the...
Yeah, that comes out that way. The sanitary rules and rights came out, and they got a lot of attention.
That's another one, cemetery. I've got a copy of the pleasantries from the senior newsletter. You could put a little public service on that.
Sure.
And John, we were going to talk about, is there a draft of the regs?
No, the regs, we didn't. You want me to make his copy?
No, I can open them on my computer. Or, oh, we were going to talk a little bit as well, too, about this week, I think under penalties, violations of penalties.
Yes.
Is something we needed to discuss.
Yes. So, I know we spoke about the first, violation to be a warning.
The problem that we run into for any, the more I thought about this, for any monetary violation that our fine that we levy on someone is, well, I'm assuming we'd have to prove it, in other words, by means of testing or otherwise, through an investigation.
The health agent didn't witness the actual application.
Right.
What would be the standard of deciding who's responsible? I had the same.
I tried to reach out to Marblehead. I got no call back.
Well, I got an email, Andrew Petty.
Petty, yes, thank you.
I got an email back from him.
To see how they were handling it.
Yes.
Did you get
he he indicated to me that there was no problems. That they hadn't had any problems.
Just complying.
Well, so they haven't levied any violations?
They have not had violations.
But did they talk about how they handled it, or is it just?
He got back to me. We were back and forth texting twice.
Okay.
The first time he talked about the classifications of pesticides,
yeah,
levels for the EPA levels. And then he got back to me and said, well, and I asked him specifically about how were they handling violations and what were the citizens' responses to the regulations. And he just basically tested me back that it's only town land. It was only town land and they haven't had any problems. And I texted him back, but I didn't hear back from him again. So I texted him twice after that, didn't hear back.
So does that mean they don't apply it on only town land, and you can do?
Well, his regulations are like ours. It only applies to town. Yeah. Town
owned land. Restrictions of the to powers of the board.
Are theirs written the same? Sidewalks and tree lawns.
Theirs are just written.
Or is it just saying town
land? Town owned land.
Okay.
Town owned land.
Got it. All right. So that's one of my only concerns is how we'll actually be able to. How you actually be able to levy a fine. You know, of course, you levy the fine and the person pays it, it's no problem. But if they say, wait a minute, how do you know I've done that?
And they fess up and say, yeah, I put halts down on your tree lawn, I guess they've admitted it and then you know. But if a neighbor sees them putting something down there and reports it,
mm-hmm.
How do they know they're not just putting fertilizer down, which I presume is still okay?
Mm-hmm. And then what if the neighbor just doesn't like the neighbor?
Yeah.
And says, I saw them doing that.
Yeah.
So I think we should talk carefully about how we want to roll this out.
We might just have to take a sample. Mm.
Do you have the ability to test?
How do we test that? And who pays for that?
We have to get it.
All good questions.
We have to get it tested.
Any idea how much that costs or where you go to do that or who pays for it?
I could find that out. I'm sure we could get that tested.
Can you tell I don't know what it is. Can you tell, I would imagine one, years ago when someone did something like very egregious on a sidewalk on Middlesex and High, the sidewalk was coated, it just took a picture of it, and I did file a complaint with the Board of Health at that time.
Mm-hmm.
I have no idea what it was, but that never happened again.
Yeah.
But can you tell when, so I only know it's an issue because I can see it, or I step on it, I can see the granules. Can you tell physically whether or not from the granules, whether it's fertilizer shouldn't be on the sidewalk either. But can you tell?
You're not regulated fertilizer.
No.
Correct. I cannot tell.
I can't tell.
I think they actually dye it now so that if you're putting grass seed down, it's a different color, so you don't even know it's under the dye unless you analyze it.
Yeah, the only way you really be able to tell is to get it tested, I believe, whether it was fertilizer or herbicide. Pesticide.
The board would want to have some information on what that would cost, and we'll do it.
Okay.
Just speaking as one member.
Mm-hmm.
And then how do you prove that it was, if it's on the curb cut, how do you prove that it was that homeowner and it wasn't somebody walking by that just doesn't like that homeowner?
What if you just made it an initiative in that you were going for 100% compliance and as opposed to a regulation? I don't know, just say it's a two-town initiative and with 90 to 100%, 100% compliance. Just to inform people. I mean, I don't know.
Well, I think that would be buttressed by having a warning for the first.
Warning, yeah.
And some language like that in here. No.
Maybe the fines are to be determined by the scenario.
Well, you can do that and revisit it. It's one way to do it.
Yeah, I mean, I think a warning would be, the first warning would be sufficient. For us, I would like to be a little stronger if they would continue to do that. I just I'd like there to be a little more.
Yeah. First, second, third. I think if you add the warning and your other numbers look reasonable to me.
So,
I'm thinking you might want to test in two spots if you're going to test, because what if somebody doesn't like somebody and they just walk by and they're like, oh yeah, I'm walking my dog, and they sprinkle this stuff, then you can also test up by their house.
That's, well, anybody
possible, but a little far-fetched, I'd say. Not the most likely cause.
I mean, I see people spraying Roundup and stuff like on the,
I got a perfect example. It was down the street. The guy is, he's doing herbicide. There was a whole lot covered with trees. He cut it all down, and it's dirt and rocks, and it looks like hell. And he keeps spraying more herbicides on it. Even on the town, what is he going to do? I had no idea. I think he might be building an accessory building on the side, either an apartment or a garage. But I've heard that for a year.
So are we in agreement that the first offense should be a warning?
Can we call it a written notice of policies rather than a warning? No. A warning still implies that we know what you've put down there and would require an investigation to figure that out. I think it's easier to send a letter to say, it was noticed that you have a chemical down there, just so you're aware. Our policies now is this. If it is in fact a pesticide, it's not allowable. I think it's an easier, faster mechanism to get the public on board. I think it's also a little bit easier mechanism for our town staff that is open right now, too, to not have to investigate a warning, right? Only to investigate a second offense that looks like, okay, no, you know, it's the same thing. Now we have to go back and look at it.
Okay, so any person who violates the provision of these regulations shall receive a letter of notice of regulations. Is that?
Yeah. No, the notice of the pesticide policy.
Yeah.
Okay. And could you put it in the tax bill? Because that would go to owners.
Yeah, but this would be if someone complains about it.
This is a formal complaint. Yes,
right.
Formal, what we do. And second offense, I'll put a fine in. A letter and fine.
I think if it's going to be a serious regulation, you have to do something, Kevin.
Oh, you have to put something on it, yeah. I'm just trying to...
Either that or calling into a hearing.
To figure out the easiest way to...
Should the board call him before the board? Would that be sufficient?
So there's a couple of, there's always a couple of factors at play here, right? So the easiest thing to, as part of the policy and rolling it out, certainly get it out to every company that you can think of that services homes in Reading, right? Mm-hmm. So get it out to the professionals first so they're well aware. That's going to greatly reduce any exposure right off the bat, because most people aren't doing it themselves. I'd say in Reading.
A lot fewer.
I mean, I'd have to take a survey. My guess would be the higher number, because I see all these trucks in and around everywhere, right? Mm-hmm. So I guess the higher number of people aren't doing it themselves. So that's the easier one, you know, folks to reach. The higher folks to reach are the homeowners. And then, again, it comes down to, I want to make sure that we have something that's that allows us to effectively identify. That's not costlier than the fine, right? That's why I'm a little hesitant to put a number on it as of right now, as opposed to one to be determined by case-by-case basis.
Like I said, we could subject to a meeting before the board, subject to a fine. And then we can determine, the board can determine the causality of what they, if they did it, and then determine whether we would subject them to a fine.
Okay.
That's in the second offense.
Would this be a ticketing kind of thing? Or look, can you ticket people?
Yeah.
Okay. See if we have that power. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you would act as sort of an appellate board. Is that the idea? Or
well, come before the board and explain what you're doing.
Yeah.
On the second offense. I mean, if you first offense, you get a warning. Right. Okay.
Yeah, especially in a sense of what any kind of testing would cost.
The board's going to want to hear that next week, I think.
Yeah, that's my guess, too. Because that to me determines where you want to go with the fine, right? So if it's a $50 test,
well, if we
fine some $25.
If we bring them before the board, could we have them test what they're putting on there?
So we'd want to be the body that pays for the testing, because we want it to be our test. Mm-hmm. We don't want a homeowner telling us, oh yeah, here, I tested it and here's the result. Not that I'm saying I don't trust people. I'm just saying from the standpoint of, you know, controlling the information, we'd want to pay for it because we'd want to be the client in that case of having it tested through that laboratory.
Can we make the citizen bear the cost of the test?
Well,
I think Kevin's saying you set the fine structure to cover that.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Make sure that I just want to make sure that we cover it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just saying, I'd love to know. Okay, is it a simple test? Is it a one size fits all? In other words, doesn't matter the pesticide. You know, we're going to be able to charge you the same amount for any of them to test it and just find out what exactly entails all that. That's why I was trying to get a hold of Mar with that, and it sounds like they don't have any information anyways to give us. Mm-hmm. Sounds like they haven't elevated at that point.
We need to find out what we have to bring too. We'd like to have to bring grass, dirt, and.
Yeah, so that cost really, I think, to me, determines the number, right, on that second offense.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
There was some meeting a while ago that somebody said that the companies that do the spraying have already haven't been spraying, that they've already been not doing that strip of. I don't remember that they've already been. So I don't think that they only spray the lawns. I don't think they're spraying that strip. Because you see the little sign. Yeah, I think that they're not.
They shouldn't be.
They only see the signs right on the lawns. I can't remember who mentioned that, but mm-hmm. someone said that they're already aware of.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They're aware, but I think there's a gray area where there's mm-hmm. no sidewalk. And there's no clear
definition of
where the lawn is and the tree lawn
okay.
Common property starts.
Right.
Now, how long do you think it would take to educate the public?
2 years.
In other words, what?
That was a serious statement.
Oh, sorry.
No, I understand. It sounds like a long period of time, but to educate is to get people to fully be aware of it. And that's, I mean, what do they say? It takes 66 days to make a habit into your daily routine.
Bad habits take much less time.
Much less time, yeah. Right. But I think my thought would be, you know, a couple of spring cycles, right, where we'd want to probably send out in the water bills before, two spring cycles.
So, yeah, but we're not trying to change behavior. We're just trying to alert them of something that they shouldn't be doing. I mean, you know, I understand your habit thing, but
right.
I mean, we're not trying to break them of a habit. We're just trying to let them know that you can't do this.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, it's the same thing if they're doing it right now, but we do want them to change their behavior.
Yes. Yes.
Like I said, but I think for the companies, it's easy. It's as soon as you notify them.
Right.
You know.
Right. But I mean, I would look forward to if this gets approved by the Board of Selectmen to spend the next few months, several months, publicizing these
mm-hmm.
and set a date so early next spring that we can institute the policy.
Is it the same amount of feet on every street?
No.
No, that's a challenge.
It depends on
the. I don't even know if it's the same amount of feet if there's a sidewalk. I think it changes off that sidewalk too.
There was a standard with the new subdivision regulations about how much right of way exists for sidewalk and street. But
right.
when you go to the older streets, before we had Board of Survey, it varies all over the place, I think.
Yeah, I think the last time we're looking at stuff like this at a town meeting,
yeah.
it ranged from like 3 feet to 15 feet.
It is definitely variable.
Yeah, it was a big change. I think the average is somewhere around six, but it changed.
So know. Do we go with the average in the letter, or do we tell them they have to look it up?
So this policy,
you have to go with some presumptive limit on feet, so people have.
But correct me if I'm wrong. Is this policy only is talking about sidewalks and tree lawns, though?
Yeah, correct.
It's not talking about property that doesn't have a sidewalk.
Oh yeah, it is. Tree lawns exist even when there's no sidewalk.
So tree lawn exists without a sidewalk.
Okay, the public property is...
Tree lawn is...
It's there.
Okay.
Not as a sidewalk, the town owns that strip of...
Is that...
That's...
Is that the technical?
It's technical.
Because a tree lawn, to me, always was left literally that little strip, so you could put a tree.
It's the public right away in that part.
If there's no, sidewalk, is that what we still call that?
You're still talking about public land, publicly owned land. Whether it would be called a tree lawn or not.
Do we have the verb publicly owned?
I always took tree lawn to mean either one.
Yeah, it is public.
Sure.
You can define tree lawn.
Yeah, I just want to make sure that we're very clear on that.
Well, like the third...
So we should be clear on how many feet we're talking to.
To the inner extent of the sidewalk, where there is one, or X number of feet in from the street.
Okay, so it says the town-owned land that these regulations pertain to are the sidewalks and tree lawns.
Yeah.
So long as that's...
Unless you're carrying a plat map, right, you're not going to know where the...
No, you're not, but I want to be very clear on that. That tree lawn, to me, almost could be a little subjective if someone doesn't have a sidewalk.
Well, that's where the main problem is here.
Yeah, I mean, just the fourth paragraph, number three, to encourage the reduction and elimination of use of toxic pesticides on town-owned land.
Okay.
Town-owned land, and then sidewalks and tree lawns.
And so all I really need to do is figure out costs.
Costs.
And the costs will determine what we do for the ticket.
Yeah. And I can look into the actual cost of testing pellets. So as far as submission to the Board of Selectmen, can we make this a warning? Any person who violates any provision of these pest management regulations shall be subject to a warning.
But you're going to not use that language? Issue a notice of policy or something?
Letter of notice of pesticide policy.
Yeah, there you go.
Well, yes, but violation of these management regulations will receive a warning letter of...
Warning letters.
Warning letter of notice of regulations.
With letter, yeah.
And subject for the first offense.
Yeah. And you can just leave this, the second and third blank until you have your...
I would leave it just to be determined.
Yeah.
You don't know anything that we vote on today, we can always just change that.
Once you do your homework, you can maybe advance another next week.
Then we can just modify it.
And that can be put in later. That's not enough time.
And effective date, should we work towards an effective date?
When do the water bills come out?
Yeah, it just came out for, it's due in July, so there won't be another one until September.
Until September, yeah. Right, it's quarterly, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So then we have a couple, okay.
Property tax bills run about the same cycle also.
Yes.
Yeah, both of those.
March 1, 2019. So it should be early enough, right?
Yep, that'll give us time to publicize it.
Time to publicize it. That's before any applicators.
Is it fair to say we're past the major application period, crabgrass and all that?
For now, for this year?
Yeah. I'm not an expert there.
Well, by the time we got all of our notifications out, I think it would be. And we still, you're probably going to want to do some work on it too.
Sure.
So So it might be too late for this year.
Yeah.
Because we're gonna want to publicize it in papers, bills, flyers, you know, senior center.
So is the Board of Health willing to handle that part of it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep. Board along with the town. Will Matt be able to get some stuff in for us into the town website?
Let me know if she's okay with it.
Thank you.
I'm not taking
that either. I can talk to the senior. We can communicate with the DPU. So we will shoot for a March 1st effective date.
2019.
And we'll see what the Board of Selectmen
would
like to hear. Yes, ma'am.
Can I make a couple brief remarks?
Certainly.
One is, thank you. And the second, step, I would recommend definitely having a flat fine. It just levels the playing field, and everyone knows to become a board of arbitration and kind of, you know, not having a specific fine just creates too many problems for the board. So I would recommend, once you know what the testing has cost enough to cover that testing, if that needs to be pursued, would be reasonable, especially if they've been given the warning in addition to all the publicity. That's just my thought. It just makes it clear everyone's treated the same, and there's no, you know, dickering back and forth. It just creates too much of a hassle. Second, the thing with Marblehead is Marblehead's regulations have been, in fact, probably 20 years or more, so it's a different...
That's right. I thought it was like 2008. No, was it a lot longer?
It's been a very long time. Okay. They had very grassroots campaign years and years ago. They were one of the groundbreaking communities on this issue. So some of it's just known.
Right.
So they probably don't have
it.
And
that
fell probably... You know, wasn't even there when those were first.
That could be. Yeah.
So that's what I'm thinking that you might be running up against with Marblehead.
You were laughing at my 2 years.
Yeah, I mean, it didn't seem like he knew much about it just in his responses to me. And I was,
it's an old
which
issue.
Means
it's
not
a very old
which
issue.
I guess they're not getting any good points because he doesn't know much about it.
Yeah, it must
be
very old.
Probably
don't
deal with day in, day out stuff.
Yeah, okay. It's probably just part of the community culture at this point. Thank you.
Okay.
Maybe you could do some on Town Day in the fall too. Maybe it would be the Town Day or something. I don't know if you can have a booth.
Yeah, the town usually does have a booth.
Yeah, you could do, because that's in the fall before.
Yeah, I'm sure there'd be other. There's a lot of folks that have a booth that probably wouldn't mind having that information on it.
Sure.
Or allow you to have it on there.
And I think maybe just a flyer notifying people that you can't do this.
Right.
I mean, we're not going to give them the regulations, but you know, basically, you can't. You know, you shouldn't be applying your weed killer to the public land on the sidewalk. Flyers of that. This, you know, remind them that this is now a regulation of the Board of Health regulation, and this is what it means.
Maybe put it like positive, like protect our children, and that's kind of a positive. Let's do this together. Let's make it a positive, kind of not like
that's a good
point. Slapping your hand, but
just want to recruit you too.
I'll help out. Sorry, I'm like improving everyone's quality of life, really.
Sure.
Really.
Oh yeah, I agree.
Like
absolutely.
In the police station, they have a bunch of flyers and things. You know, when you go to fill out your accident report, there's always things I'm looking over there. So. You could put something
in.
That's
a good point. Good point.
I know a lot of people are more electronic than, you know.
Okay. Well, we'll have to post our presence. I don't know, is the rest of the board planning on being there next week?
Yeah, I can.
Because we'll have to post our presence
whenever it's on the agenda.
It would be advisable for you to post it. Two or more, you will be there.
Yeah, you should probably post.
Okay.
You can't really sit, talk much if you know.
That's true. Can't talk at all.
No. So, are you clear? Do we have a document that we can submit to the Board of Selectmen now? Have we made changes?
Sir, I could advise you. We should take a vote.
Yes, but I mean, it's just as. Do we have a document? have you been making changes as we've been going?
I'm just typing your notes. I'm not making
any
changes.
So the only change is what we talked about in the penalties. So why don't you read that again, just so everyone's 100% on that, because we'll use yours as the notes.
Okay.
And we'll give that to Kristen after a vote, so we want to make sure we have that language just the way we want it right there. Read me what you have. Yeah.
I've got any person who violates any provision of these pest management regulations shall be subject to a warning letter of notice of regulations for a first offense. And then we're going to leave this.
And where the money is, yeah, just the money, $30, just put a TB, yeah.
And for a second and subsequent offenses, to be determined. Yeah.
That works. I'm fine with that.
Just one grammatical thing I caught under section two, last paragraphs. The last regulations for the public health and safety relative to the word TO, nuisances and causes of sickness, should be inserted. Relative to nuisances.
Regulations of public health and safety relative to nuisances. Okay. Relative to nuisances and causes of sickness. Okay.
And can you read the warning just one more time? Because you have like two. You said something.
Well, I was just trying to. Mm-hmm. Any person who violates any provision of these pest management regulations shall be subject to a warning letter of notice of regulations. Or I could just put subject to a letter of notice.
Yeah,
of pesticide.
Yeah, that might be better. Yeah.
I'll take the warning out.
Yeah.
It's a little wordy.
Yeah. Subject to a letter of notice of regulations.
Right, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that's good. Good catch.
I'll take warning out. Letter of regulations for a first offense and for a second and subsequent offenses to be determined.
Fine to be determined.
And your effective date under section 12 will be 3/1/2019.
3/1/2019, right. Now, Dan, what do you think the board is going to need? What are you looking? Have you?
Final voted copy of your proposed regulation, your presence, and you might want to just send a cover memo saying that you're investigating the cost of testing, and that the fines will be informed in part by what that results in.
Okay.
So I think that's sufficient. Be there to answer questions.
Very good. So do we hear a motion on the acceptance of our pesticide regulations?
Make a motion to accept the pesticide regulations or pesticide policy as constructed.
As constructed for presentation to the selectmen.
I second the motion. Right.
Second motion. Any further discussion? All in favor? Aye. Aye. All opposed? No one. 3-0. And David, thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. We went a little over our 5:30 scheduled meeting. Thank you for coming.
Yeah. Thanks. Where do you want me to stand?
You can sit right here. It's fine. Thank you. A little room here.
So I'm here. I'm on the Climate Advisory Committee, but I'm not here as a Climate Advisory Committee person. I'm here just as a citizen. In part because we haven't discussed this with the Climate Advisory Committee, because they don't meet till tomorrow, right? But anyway, I'm asking the board to consider sending a letter to the governor of of Massachusetts, asking him to do an analysis of the effects of natural gas on the health of residents, and then to ask him to implement a process that would, where when he's considering new infrastructure, like new pipelines, new power plants, or expansions of the distribution system or something, that they that a, an assessment be done of any dangers or whatever for the to the health because of that pipeline. So I brought some handouts here. I sent you this in an email.
Did. Yes, I got started last night as I was saying earlier.
Okay, so that's part of it. And I'll tell you what we're looking at and then what it's about. So let's see if I can see it. So there are two parts. So there are 67 towns in boards of health in Massachusetts that have sent such letters to the governor or joined in a joint letter to the governor about this to evaluate the health risks of natural gas infrastructure in Massachusetts and ask him to require that a comprehensive health impact statement be completed to evaluate those health risks before any new or expanded natural gas infrastructure is approved. So the health risks are, there are two parts to the health risks. The part of it is this is the toxins that are actually in natural gas. And a lot of the toxins that are in natural gas, that benzene or formaldehyde, tend to be products of the fracking process. In other words, they're inserted into the wells and then comes back out with the gas. Some of them are heavy metals like lead and mercury. Some of them are radioactive elements like radon or lead that are just happen to be in the shale, you know, and so they're brought back out with the gas as well. And then particulates. Of course, gas obviously has damage that can cause damage by fires and explosions. And the other part of the health is that natural gas, if it escapes the system, you know, contributes to ozone creation and asthma and things like that. And here's the research. I've got several resources in your packet here. The one is the list of towns, the 67 towns. Another is the position. The second item is the position of the Massachusetts Medical Society, which is a very simple statement of where, of saying that they concur with this, evaluating this, the health effects of natural gas. Another is just a flyer. It's just a two-page flyer on the effects of natural gas. The fourth is a draft letter to the governor. So the letter that's in this packet is like a two-page letter that goes through this explanation of what we would send. The idea would be that you would, you know, edit this letter to your own satisfaction, you know, and send that in. Some towns that have sent in letters have sent in very simple letters. I mean, letters that are almost down to the what is the medical society's position, you know, okay. Just a paragraph, you know. I mean, it's just kind of whatever you would be comfortable with and however involved you wanted to get with it. And then after that, there's also a letter from the Massachusetts Association of Health Boards. A year ago, they did this soliciting letters, really soliciting sign-ons from health boards where they provide the letter and then they just listed a bunch of signatories. And that's still an option if you feel more comfortable with the Mass Association of Health Boards, you know, to just say, you know, me too, and put writing down that's a possibility. So you can either send your own letter or, you know, sign on to their letter. And pass out this too on here. So this is just to give you a feel for what's happening. This last thing is, this is actually, I only brought one copy of that, but I'll leave that with you. It's an indoor study. Of gas in the house, you know, the importance of ventilation for gas stoves as opposed to this, the gas just, you know, venting into the house itself. You're looking at two things. One is the sort of a status on where gas leaks are. So at the end of last year, there were 95 natural gas leaks in Reading. And if you look at this part, this page, you can see that we're not really going anywhere. You know, there was about that many at the end of 2014, 2015, 2016. And in the meantime, you know, I mean, we are getting new leaks. Some of the leaks are dangerous leaks, some of them are not. But basically, the number of leaks that are being repaired in Reading are the same as the number of new leaks. I mean, it's just, and the total is not really changing. That, there's nothing special about Reading. This is the case for Massachusetts. In Massachusetts, there are over 17,000 leaks. And in Massachusetts, there are about 16,000 new leaks every year. And 16,000 leaks are fixed every year. So,
now, is this just bad pipes?
It is.
Bad connections?
Yeah, at this point, there's two things. One, it's just old pipes. And Reading actually has among the older style of pipes, the same kind of pipes that Boston has, the same kind that Lowell has. Mm-hmm. But in addition to that, these things were originally designed for, if you remember, with manufactured gas. It was a coal gas. It was made from coal. It was very wet. And the pipes were actually sealed together with oakum, jute. It's just a vegetable material that was used as a sealant. The natural water in the coal gas would cause that to swell and seal. Mm-hmm. Natural gas is methane. It doesn't do that. It just dries out and leaks. So every 12 feet you have a leak in a nice pipe. But the pipes themselves are getting old. I mean, the only thing that's going to really...
You're aware we're replacing large portions of our gas infrastructure.
Everywhere that they...
Yellow pipes, seeing them all.
When they put... That's the only solution. You know, putting in the new plastic pipes eliminates that problem. But that's still... We got a ways to go, you know? So that is the part that's causing methane to be released into the air. That's the part that's causing, the oxidation, the asthma, the things like that. The other part is the elements that are in the gas itself. If it didn't leak at all, these are the things that are coming out of your stove when you cook. You know, the toxin, the radioactive materials, and the heavy metals. So this is just to get. To get the state to pay attention to this, mm-hmm. and to first of all do an evaluation of health risks from the gas, and the second is to consider that when they're considering new infrastructure, which they are. I mean, you've heard the stories about new transmission lines, and
yes,
also you've heard the stories of new distribution lines to within the local distribution companies as they expand their service. So.
Is this part of an effort to urge that we not build that kind of thing?
It is. I mean, it's a...
You should disclose your membership as the chair of the Democrat Town Committee. Are you, in fact...
I'm not. I am on the Democratic Town Committee.
Right, and this is a political issue. It's a political year, so that's on the table.
Well, yeah. It's not a political issue. It's an environmental issue, and I am an environmentalist, and I am a member of the Climate Advisory Committee, but I'm not bringing this on their behalf. Right, but I am an environmentalist, and I am bringing it in the sense that natural gas is a problem. It's 50% of the electricity in Massachusetts is generated from natural gas.
60%. Which is the cleanest burning hydrocarbon. You would admit that, right?
Yeah, it's methane.
It's far preferable to coal and oil.
If it didn't leak, you know, when you talk about burning, yes, but if you talk about methane leaking into the air, it's really no better. And if you talk about carcinogens that are coming into this gas, they're not really methane, but they're just coming in because of the fracking process, that's the issue here. It's what else is not in the gas, and it's the fact that the gas is leaking out of the pipe. That's the issue.
Only the stoves, though, the studies. Just talks about stoves, but not.
It's far more gruesome inside.
It's like when you turn the stove on, is that what? Because it's not talking about dryers, gas dryers.
No, anything that burns. So when you furnace, you know, your water heater, because that stuff doesn't burn necessarily when you turn your stove on. You know, some of it may burn, but. That's not the burning part of natural gas. The burning part of natural gas is methane, right? CH4.
Right. Yes.
So yeah, it just comes out anyway and just floats around. And that study, you know, it goes into basically what they've seen in houses that were venting their stoves versus not. You know, your furnace is vented, it's going up a chimney, right? Your water heater is vented, it's going up a chimney. But your stoves are not, and that's why it's an issue. But it exists anyway. So this is definitely, this is, and that little two-page flyer about gas is really, I mean, the point of that is really trying to say, not that thing, but it's in the packet. It's basically saying that it's time to stop thinking of natural gas as a bridge fuel and start.
Well, that's where it gets political, in my humble opinion.
That's fine. That's not the Democratic Party's position, okay? And it's not the Reading Democratic Town Committee's position either. It is my position. All right, I'll tell you that.
And you're allowed to have.
So this is what I'm asking. I'm asking for you to consider, as a board, sending such a letter along like the 67 boards of health that have already done this, and to add your name to the list.
To study the effects.
To evaluate the effects of natural gas, and two, to use that information in the evaluation of further gas infrastructure projects. Does that make sense? Have I gone too fast, or what? Or what's your?
Gotcha.
There's some like other articles that maybe you could read. That you cite.
Yeah.
That whole last page on has a bunch of references. If you care to dig in, you can. And if you got the electronic version that I sent John, then you've got the hyperlinks.
My suggestion would be where this was brought into the public discussion. We should put this on a future board meeting, so it's on an agenda and posted, so we can discuss it.
Okay.
Come back.
Yeah. You meet like monthly, right?
Yes. Monthly. Yeah.
Yeah, that would be great.
That work?
Because I'd like to read a little more about it. I got it last night. I browsed through it to see.
I got that.
I did get my attention.
I wasn't thrilled at the thought. I mean, I just kind of got into this, and the fact that the board meeting was tonight wasn't convenient for me either. Okay. But I really wanted to get it in front of you, and I
right.
had no problem with coming back and diving in a little more.
Absolutely, we can get it on the agenda for a later meeting. That's absolutely it. We'll have a chance to go over.
Yeah, I think it gives us a better chance to digest it too. And I always would not that I appreciate you coming in for the public meeting, but always taking it from there and then discussing that right then and there where the public really has been notified that we're discussing the issue.
I don't think boards generally decide
unless
they're just that way.
Right, right.
Yeah. So
would you like that the next meeting?
What do we have on for the next meeting? Is it?
I believe we're going to have one in July. I think we've got one on the schedule for July.
Do you know what date?
17th. Unless we're changing it to
July 17th. Ouch. Okay.
That's a Tuesday.
Oh, you're still here for the next one, correct?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so July 17th.
We are discussing. Do we want to talk about during the meeting the potential date change for the meeting?
Yes, I said I was gonna bring up with Laura.
Heidi's still here for the next one.
Right.
But then we need to change it. The one after that?
Potentially starting in July.
Okay.
Yeah.
So they were thinking of changing it to Wednesdays on July?
That's 7. I'll tell you why. We have a candidate, and only one candidate for Heidi's position who cannot make 5:30 on Tuesdays, would struggle to make 7 on Tuesdays, but can make 7 on Wednesdays.
Okay.
And I know you have situations that you need to deal with, too. So I'm looking for optimal balance between the two schedules.
Sure.
It used to be Wednesdays, right?
It used to be Wednesdays at 5:30.
On 5:30.
Yeah, so, this is not, for me, later is always better. Tuesday, Wednesday is fine. It doesn't matter which day it is.
And it's important in terms of the pool of candidates that we can muster for this board, which is very important. Mm-hmm.
So if we did Tuesdays, what time would it be at?
She'd struggle to meet 7. It would have to be probably 7:30. I don't know how that plays with your schedule. Yeah.
Hmm. So it defeats a lot of the purpose of us going to Tuesdays at 5:30 to stay under the hours of town hall.
Does that incur overtime for you? Or what could I ask? Oh, you, yes, of course. Okay. So your option. I'm sorry.
So TBD. I mean, as far as
yes.
I do not. No. John has an electronic copy.
I could probably send that to Laura.
You send it to Laura, John? Yeah, perfect.
Distribute it to you.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Okay.
Fine.
That'd be good.
All right.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
How many applicants do we have?
Kind of.
So, this is my personal problem. I understand that it's my problem,
sure.
Not yours, but if we stay Tuesdays.
Yeah.
I already have Nana that watches my kid. I could ask her to do a sleepover every Tuesday. If we do Wednesdays, then she would have to stay with them late Tuesdays and Wednesdays. So I guess it would be better to do Tuesdays for me.
Because of your late hours Tuesday. Yeah, okay. Okay.
Tuesdays at 7?
We'd have to be 7:30.
Oh, yes. 7:30. I'll push it for 7. Let's see if that'll work.
7:30?
See what we can do. Keep it early for you. Yeah.
Either way, it's not going to be early enough to... get my kid.
Oh.
Would that work for you or no? Wednesday better?
No.
Good.
No. Yeah, Tuesdays would actually end up being better. I have an hour commute and I have home issues too, so.
Okay, so.
Your wife's home, right?
Hmm?
Your wife's home with the kids, right?
So I wasn't here tonight. Sitting in traffic.
So Tuesdays are still preferable for the majority of folks here.
Yeah, I mean,
as early as
in all honesty, Tuesdays at 5:30 is still preferable.
That's
I'd hate to see a board bend. Everyone's schedules around to accommodate one member, and I'm not trying to be unfair in saying that, but
I'm mindful of that. Yeah.
You know, moving forward. And we lose another member, we get another member on, and now Tuesday at 7:30 doesn't work.
Yeah,
I feel like you're going to start going around the circle.
Sure.
I think you need to set up all this, you know, time and a date, what's going to work for the majority of the board and the staff, and that needs to be the time and the date. One of the questions asked, as you're well aware of,
right.
is are you able to meet the commitment? The commitment's
right.
Tuesdays at 5:30.
I think what she had interviewed previously was Wednesday, and that was a better day for her at the time. Yeah, I'll pursue and see if she can get in earlier on Wednesday to see if that's still an option. Would a 6:30 on Wednesday work?
Everything works for me, Dan. So,
at what point, if we push it back on Wednesday, does it work?
I don't want to make this unreasonable for the staff.
No,
is my sole point here.
But you can see what's happening. We're losing one member because of this.
I know. I understand. The state needs to make this a 5-member panel.
Nobody's a villain here. Nobody's
not a 3-member. That's why.
Yeah.
All right. We'll talk about it some more. I'll get back to the applicant.
So, but the consensus is that Tuesday is best.
Still better.
For staff, Tuesday is best.
I'm hearing that.
Tuesday's best. Tuesday, yeah, I mean, that's simply the best within town hall hours, which is up until 7 o'clock.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let's see what I can do.
Okay.
So 7:18 is a Tuesday.
I mean, even Tuesday at 6, where you can get an hour meeting in.
Prospective candidate is 7 is going to be the earliest that it can
I think so. Is the place she's got to be out of town between 5 and 6:30. Her family member.
And usually, like next week is supposed to be Wednesdays. I have zoning board meetings, so Wednesdays
will
work.
Okay, that's important to know.
So next week was the original Board of Health meeting, so I usually have health and zoning in the same back to back.
Told me. Yeah. All right, I will take it up with her. Thanks.
Very good.
Sorry to hear everybody's personal lives here.
Sorry.
Yeah.
No. So we have a tentative meeting for tomorrow night, but we don't need it now, correct?
We don't need tomorrow.
No.
Okay.
No.
So for
that's what I had in my head for Wednesday.
So for July, are we still deciding, or because we still have Heidi, are we just going to stick with our Tuesday the 17th?
Stick with
Tuesday the 17th, 5:30.
Yep, that sounds good.
And then you'll need to post us for this coming Tuesday, the 19th.
Yeah,
at
7 o'clock.
Or July, or?
Well, I know, it's, if we post for 7, it doesn't matter.
Your term will be up, but you can attend as a...
You're coming to Tuesday the 17th at 5:30, correct, Heidi?
Oh, no, I was thinking next week. I thought we had...
I'm looking to see exactly.
June 19th.
That's
the Board of Selectmen.
To be, to have, just sit in on the Board of Selectmen's meeting, where they're going to discuss the policy that we just voted on.
So we'll post that, right?
Yes, we should post that, so we can all be there.
5:30. I have to just look at my...
Yeah.
What time, Board of Selectmen meeting?
Just post it at 7, at 7 o'clock, because that way, it doesn't matter what time we get on their schedule. Probably won't be till 8:30-ish, I'm guessing.
Yeah, we should throw that.
But yeah, that'll cover it.
Well, I can get back to you before you have to post it and let you know exactly when, so you're not sitting there for an hour.
For the Board of Health meeting?
Well,
What time you're...
So the only, it's just for the Board of Health to attend, not for the health agent or...
Yeah, I'm not sure you need
to attend. They don't need to be in attendance.
I don't think you have to be there. No, this is just for us.
Just for the members.
Just for your convenience, so you're not...
But we do have to have it posted so we can both be there.
Yeah.
Or all be there.
Yeah, here's for 6:30.
Yeah. Which was the end of June.
Okay.
I don't know, I don't have my schedule. I don't know anybody.
Do you want us to reappoint you as an associate? We could.
I know.
If you still want to keep coming, then you wouldn't be obliged to come to every single meeting. We'd hate to lose you all together. Is that something that might work?
About it, just some days it's just when I'm coming from Boston.
Yeah.
I don't get out till 5, it's like, and you can't leave early.
Sure.
It's just,
They're
unreasonable. Like, you can't leave. Healthcare is the worst. But if I'm in Danvers, no problem. I'm out at 3:30. I work both jobs, so.
All right, I'll get back to you on exactly what time. Thanks, Heidi.
Yeah, because if you're having trouble filling it, I just don't know if I can do three years, but...
And I will, I'll make the changes on this, and when do we have to have that to send to the selectmen?
By Thursday, right?
Yeah, the packet goes out Thursday.
Ideally we should get it to him tomorrow.
I can do it tomorrow morning. I don't have to be in work until tomorrow afternoon.
Do you have the original?
Well, it's all marked. I've got a copy of a draft of it, and it's all marked up. Where is it? So I'll go in and I'll just...
But you have the electronic copy that you can make the changes on?
Yes, I have.
Is this a meeting next week that the public...
So you can make all the changes on it?
Next Tuesday?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's a public Board of Selectmen.
What time?
Hey, if you can type up in the morning,
the meeting starts at 7,
I can actually just send it off. I can send it off to you. I'll do that even for tomorrow morning.
The big scary thing.
I'm thinking I can give you a copy, but
I've seen one to you.
I can just send it to you.
I'm going to need to go, still have minutes to do.
Yeah.
Send it everybody again, and just send the copy to Caitlin to include in the packet for the selectmen for Thursday.
Thank you.
So you're
going
to go to the board.
Good evening.
Thank you.
Correct.
The Board of Selectmen and
to
present what we're working on, and I guess we're asking for their permission to dictate town land, or have jurisdiction over town land for this regulation. I don't think that if they were to take it and make a bylaw, that would have to go through town meeting, correct? That's why I wasn't quite sure if they wanted to take it on their own, would it be a bylaw or a regulation that would have to...
Well, I thought what town council said is that the Board of Selectmen has the rights over that land,
they do
grant it.
I don't
think it would have something that has to go through town meeting.
Okay.
It didn't sound like that.
Unless I'm hoping that they can grant us permission over town for this regulation.
Right. That's what it sounded like. Mm-hmm. That's what the town council seemed to be alluding to. So.
And did you have a chance, Kevin, to go over the minutes?
I did. Yep. I went over the minutes as
two changes.
Marked. I saw that over here.
Yeah. I'd like to bring them back next week before we vote on it this week, if that's okay.
That's fine.
Sure. Yeah, there were a couple of grammatical changes on the minutes.
Do Did you have anything like that?
No.
Good?
No, we're good. I'm good.
All right, so we will table the minutes until the next meeting in July. And anything else to be brought up?
No.
Any other issues? All right. Meeting adjourned.
Most adjourned.
All right.